back again at the Moon Tower Saloon, hanging out with Lincoln, Derek, and Annalise, going through some of my new favorite closers, unbustable riddles from the book, The Book of Riddles. Check this out. I'm gonna write this down. I'm gonna draw a circle first, and I'm gonna write this phrase. In this circle, R, by which I mean the letter, that's not like representing something else. In this circle, R is present blank times. All you have to do, fill in that gap with the right word, and I will buy you drinks.
So I can't write a number. It has to be the—
Correct.
The spell ever. Okay, can I do math in that space?
You can do as much math as you want.
Oh shoot, 3 + 1 doesn't work. 2 + 2 works though.
I don't know what you're even saying, but I'm on board for all of this.
The blank has to be a word.
One of the biggest disasters when you're trying to do bar scams and score free drinks is finding yourself in a semantic argument where somebody's like, well, technically my answer was true. And I have found that in general, you can always retreat to the territory of saying, you solve this however you think is best. I'm fairly certain that whatever you write down, I have a more elegant solution that all of us will like more. If I'm wrong, I'll buy you a drink. By the way, be ready to give them a drink. But that's the right phrasing.
There's 3 R's in there. I'm going to say 1, 2, 3. And if I wrote 3, I would have 4 R's. Yep.
F-O-U-R-4 times.
Busted again! Well done, yeah. So yes, at the time you see the puzzle, there are only 3 letter R's in the circle, but the moment you write down 3, it affects the outcome and changes it, so you correctly deduced that 4 is the real solution. Well done, well done, well
Cheers.
Done. Congratulations. I'm buying you a drink.